perspective, because we've all sort of fantasized a little bit about, like, how are we going to get through this together, right? And, like, you know, you did it in a very artistic and beautiful way. My house, not the same way. So maybe you can talk a little bit about that as an inspiration.
Yeah, I've been married for 4 years, but I've been with my husband for 13. I think the thing about domestic sort of quarrels is that they can feel so singular, like it feels very much like, well, this is what we fight about. And then the more and more I spoke to my friends who were married or in long-term relationships, I realized that we were all kind of having the same exact fight. And I think there was something about the universality of that that made me want to write a story about it even more, because it seemed like there was a code waiting to be cracked. You know, like, why are we all having the same fight over and over again? And is there a way to dissect it in a way that feels fresh and also funny?
When did you show him the script?
My husband? He was not the first person to read it. I sent it to a number of people before he read it. And I feel like we were in a fight when he read it, so it wasn't the best. But no, he's an executive producer on the film, and it's super supportive.
The timing and sort of the freedom that you guys shared, and the relationships that you built as actors on the set, and how you developed the characters.
Yeah, you know, I come initially from the stage, and so to me the script is really Bible, but I also obviously wanted to create an environment where actors felt that they could make the words their own if necessary. So I think it is finding that balance of honoring the script and the dialogue as written, and making that feel as lived in and authentic and natural as possible. And I was lucky enough to work with an amazing cast of actors, so that wasn't a huge challenge. But I think it was about, for Adam and I especially, because we had never worked together before this and didn't even really know each other. So we had about 2 months of band practice before the film. Fred didn't need any band practice because he's like a legit drummer, but Adam and I were just faking it. So I think that actually built a lot of intimacy between us, sort of fast-tracked it in a way that we probably wouldn't have if we weren't having to do something as vulnerable as singing together alone in my house. But yeah, and I think that once Adam and I sort of created that intimacy, everyone else who joined on set was able to understand the tone that we were playing in. And I think for comedy, for me, my favorite comedies are grounded in a lot of, you know, real emotions, and sometimes those can be dark. And so I think having read the script, everyone knew the journey that we were on. But I also was careful to sort of explain to them that I wasn't afraid to go dark. Like, I wanted to make a movie that was like if Cassavetes made a comedy, you know, like that could really be like gnarly and bleak and voyeuristic, but also could be funny.
And also sort of the cinematography of the film sort of speaks to that as well. And working with the DP, as a director, is your first feature as a director?
Yeah,
so working with the DP on the other side of the camera now and setting up these shots and getting the look of the movie. What were you going, you mentioned Cassavetes now, but like, can you go, that's a really, I never thought of that, but yes. Can you talk a little bit about that? Like developing that, was it in the writing process where you like, I have a mental picture of how this movie's gonna look? Or was it like later on when you're like solving problems on set and you're like, we're gonna keep it consistent, but I need to do this?
It wasn't during the writing process. It was once I had finished it and I was sort of solidifying the tone, I knew that I wanted to shoot it all handheld. I think because I felt that would lend itself to more authenticity and performance. And we shot with two cameras, so that also was really helpful because, you know, we could capture a lot of nuance without having to repeat it necessarily. And I also, Woody Allen's Husbands and Wives was a big influence. And in that film, the apartment that he and Mia Farrow live in really plays a huge role in the storytelling, and the camera is super voyeuristic. But there were really long takes in that film, and that film has always been pretty meaningful to me, so I did want to play a lot with seeing how long we could go before cutting. So with my DP, we shot legit, but also the choreography was really specific because I wanted to make sure that Adam and I knew exactly what our blocking was so that we could be working in tandem with our cinematographer and B camera to not cut as much as we possibly could. And that scene in the third act, that big sort of fight scene at the climax, we did all in one take. It was a 7-minute take. We ended up cutting into it a little bit, but I think now that it's about 4 minutes without a cut.
It's incredible, yeah. It's very ambitious. Yeah.